Good morning. Good morning, our viewers across the country. Good morning, our dear learners who are listening to us. This is KUTV, a station that cares for you, even in this pandemic. A station that ensures that learning continues even when you're at home. My name is Teacher Raphael. I'm going to take you through today's math lesson. That's going to be very easy, a very easy topic that is relevant to the students in class 5, 6, 7, and 8, and mostly the students in class 8. Welcome. Make sure you are relaxed. Make sure you are seated somewhere, having a piece of paper or a book and a pen to go with me in this lesson. So our topic today is scale drawing. Our topic today is scale drawing. Scale drawing, we are going to start with introduction. Going to start introduction in the manner of definition. So what is scale drawing? We need to understand first of all what is scale drawing before we can go to the calculations. So in simple terms, scale drawing is a representation. We can say scale drawing is a representation of the real measurements on the ground on a piece of paper or on a plan or on a book or on a map. I'm sure most of you have come across maps. Atlas is the one that you normally use in class. You have come across plans of houses, plans of so many other things, plans of cars. It is very difficult for you to draw a whole road. For example, the Thika Road, that is around 50 kilometers. You don't have a book that is that size, 50 kilometers. You can imagine a giant book that is 1 kilometer plus. We don't have that. So what we do, we make use of scale drawing. And I just said it is a representation of the real measurements, of the real ground measurements on a piece of paper by use of small, accurate figures, just to make sure that whatever you are drawing, whatever is on the book, whatever is on the map, is a representation of the real object. So we can also say that scale drawing is a proportional, a two-dimensional drawing of two objects. An object on the ground that is measured either in meters or kilometers, we represent that drawing on a book, on a map, on a paper by use of centimeters, small accurate figures that can fit in a book. You can imagine what architects will be doing without this kind of work. Scale drawing is very, very useful, especially in the architect's field. Welcome, relax, and go with me. So scale drawing can be in two forms. Scale drawing can be in two forms. We have statement form, we have statement form, and we have ratio form. Just to take you through, statement form uses words. Statement form has two units. Just like saying 1 centimeter represent 80 meters. 1 centimeter represent 80 meters. That one tells you that on the ground, we have a drawing or a plan that is 80 meters. And in the paper or on a book, we have another drawing that uses 1 centimeter to represent 80 meters. 1 centimeter represent 80 meters. So the other form of scale drawing is ratio form. Ratio form is a bit different from the statement form. And if you can remember what I said about statement form, is that it uses words. It uses a keyword called represent. And some people write in short form rep to mean represent. And one side, it is centimeter. And the other side, it is the actual measurements, either in meters or kilometers. Or you can also write in centimeter. For example, in the example that I have here, 1 centimeter represent 80 meters on the ground. It can also be written as 1 centimeter represent 800 or 8,000 centimeters, or 1 centimeter represent 0.08 kilometers. So basically what we are saying, that scale drawing is a proportional two-dimension drawings, that one thing represent another thing on the ground. Going to the ratio, you can see it's a bit different. One thing, if you've noted, it doesn't have the units. It just have the ratio. There is a colon there. 1:20,000. 1:20,000. That one basically means 1 centimeter represent 20,000 centimeters on the ground, or the real measurements. Unlike statement form, which has two units, ratio form uses the same unit. You cannot see in the ratio scale, you cannot see the units, but it is well put, or rather it is assumed, that all of them are in centimeters. So we can go ahead and give examples of each. And this is how these questions are normally tested in an exam. I'm going to give you, or take you through, 5 different examples of how these questions can be tested in an exam, just to make sure that you are good, you are comfortable with it. Now, the first example we are going to learn is how to convert statement form to ratio form. How to convert statement form to ratio form. You can convert statement to ratio form, and also ratio form to statement form, by simply doing a little bit of conversions. You convert units, kilometers to meters, kilometers to centimeter, or meters to centimeters. And please note, I have said convert. I didn't say change. I know most of the students say change meters to centimeters. No, we don't say that. We say convert. When you say change, you are changing the form, the state. And when you say convert, you are changing the state, which is not correct. So we say convert. So we are going to do a little bit of conversions from one unit to another. And let us start with a very simple one for you. Conversion of statement form to ratio form. I'm going to give you an example so you can look at the screen. And that is the first one. Let us try to express statement form to ratio form using the following example. So express the scale, 1 centimeter represent 6 kilometer in the ratio form. So 1 centimeter here is the drawing length. 6 kilometer here is the real accurate measurements on the ground. So we want to see how can we convert that statement form, scale drawing, into ratio form. So like I said, we are going to go through some conversions here. So if 1 centimeter represent 6 kilometer, so the first thing we do is convert the 6 kilometer. The first thing we do is convert the 6 kilometer to centimeter. Remember what I said about ratio form. All of them are supposed to be in centimeter. So you cannot write 1:6. You cannot write 1:6. No, that one will be wrong. So you need to convert the 6 kilometer to centimeter. So to help you convert, 1 centimeter represent 100,000 centimeter. 1 centimeter represent 100,000 centimeter. 1 kilometer represent 100,000 centimeter. So what about if 1 kilometer is 100,000 centimeter? What about 6 kilometer will be what? So when you multiply 6 by 100,000, you are going to get 600,000 centimeter. So our statement scale drawing form is going to change from 1 centimeter represent 6 kilometers to 1:2. 1:600,000 centimeter. And remember, in ratio form, we don't have units. So you don't say 1:600 centimeter. You just say 1:600. Very good. That one is conversion of, that one is conversion of statement form to ratio form. So I want to take you through another example. I want to take you through another example where we are required to convert statement form to ratio form, just like the first one that I have given you. And you, I'm sure you have noted the key thing here. You just convert the real accurate measurements on the ground, that is either in meters or kilometers, into centimeters. We had been given 6 kilometers. We started by converting that 6 kilometers to centimeters by multiplying by 100,000, because 100,000 centimeter equals to 1 kilometer. Another example that I want to take you through is the same, but this time I want us to convert together. You can try from your side. Here it is. I hope you can see it. So what is the scale used if a length of 5.6 kilometer is represented by 4 centimeter on the ground? So on the ground, what we are calling drawing length is 4 centimeter. These 4 centimeter represent 5.6 kilometers on the ground. So the first thing we are supposed to do, just like we did in the first example, is to convert this 5.6 kilometer to centimeters, to convert the 5.6 kilometers to centimeters. So we can say if 1 centimeter represent 5.6 kilometer, so calculation would be 1 centimeter represent 1 kilometer represent 100,000 centimeter. What about 5.6 kilometers? So again, we multiply that to get 4 centimeter will represent how many kilometers on the ground. So we multiply and you get 1:140,000 centimeters. Remember what I said about ratio. Ratio form, we don't have units. We just have a colon there, and all the units we assume they are in centimeters. Thank you. We go to another example. Example 3. I'm going to take you through example 3. Now in example 3, we are going to see how can we convert the drawing length, the drawing measurements, to accurate or actual drawings using a scale that has been given. Remember in example 1 and 2, just to take you back, we were converting the statement form to ratio form. Now this case, I want us to convert the drawing length to accurate or actual length using a scale. And we're going to use this example. So a road on a map measures 6 centimeters. So when you measure on a map, that's on a piece of paper, it is 6 kilometers. If the scale used is 1:350,000, what is the actual of the road in kilometers? What is the actual length of the road in kilometers? Remember here, you have not been given the actual measurements. You have not been given the measurements in kilometers or meters, which we said are the actual measurements. Measurements that have those units of meters and kilometers, those ones are the ones we call actual measurements. Here, you have been given a map, and on the map, there is a road. This road is just 6 centimeters. So using the scale 1:350,000, that one means for every 1 centimeter, we get 350 centimeter. So guys at home, the first thing you are supposed to do is to convert the 350 centimeter into kilometers, or rather meters, depending on what you've been asked. For this case, we are going to convert them to kilometers. So we can say, going back to the question, we can say if 1 centimeter represent 350,000 centimeter. So we convert the 350,000 centimeters to kilometers by dividing by 100,000 centimeters. Because there before we said 100,000 centimeter equals to 1 kilometer. So we multiply 350,000 by 100,000 to get, we don't multiply, rather we divide by 100,000 to get 3.5 kilometer. So we can say that 6 centimeter on a paper or on the map, the road that is 6 centimeter, for every 6 centimeter, we have 3.5 kilometers. For every 6 centimeter, we have 3.5 kilometers. Now, what is the length of this road in the actual measurements? So we just multiply 6 by 3.5 and you get the road is 21 kilometers. You get the road is 21 kilometers. So learners, I'm sure you can see what I was talking about. You cannot draw a road that is 21 kilometers on a piece of paper. You cannot draw, or there's no book that can accommodate this kind of length. And that's how, and that's why we bring in scale drawing. We use 6 centimeters to represent 3.5 kilometers. So the road that is 6 centimeters on a map is actually 21 kilometers as real or actual measurements. We can do another example of the same, just to make sure that we are conversant with these conversions. We want to do another example where we convert the actual measurements up into scale drawing. And scale drawing, I said it is in centimeter. This time I want to give you an example of actual measurements. Then we try to use a certain ratio or scale ratio to convert the actual measurements into scale drawing. So I'll give you an example. We go through an example. So look at this example, example 4. I'm going to take you through example 4. Example 4. So a rectangular field measuring 700 meters by 400 meters. So 700 meters in this case is going to be our length. And 400 meters is going to be our width. So this field is a rectangle, just like the question has stated. Now we want to represent this field, this rectangular field, on a paper, on a book. In this case, we are going to use a scale drawing. We have been given the scale that for every 1 centimeter, we are going to get 20,000. For every 1 centimeter, it will represent 20,000 centimeters. So what did I say there? For every centimeter on the map, it is going to represent 20,000 centimeter. So just like we did in the previous example, we are going to convert the 20,000 centimeters to kilometers. So we say if one centimeter, 1 kilometer represent 100,000 centimeter. So we say 1 centimeter will represent 200 meters. Just when we convert 20,000 centimeters to meters, it will be 1 centimeter represent 200 meters. So we can ask ourselves a question. If 200 meters is represented by 1 centimeter, if 200 meters is represented on the map or on a book or on a piece of paper by 1 centimeter, what about our length of 700 meters, which is the actual measurements, will be represented by how many centimeters on the ground? So we ask ourselves a question. 200 meters is equals to 1 centimeter. What about 200, what about 700 meters? When you divide, you're going to see 3.5 centimeter is the one that will represent 700 meters. So 3.5 centimeter is on the ground, and the actual measurement is 700 meters. So we do the same with the width. We ask ourselves a question again. If 1 centimeter represents 200 meters, or you can still say the other way around, 200 meters is represented by 1 centimeter. What about our width of 400 meters will be represented by how many centimeters on the ground? So we divide and get, for every 2 centimeter, that will represent 400 meters. So our dear learners at home, we have converted the drawing, the actual measurements into scale drawing or drawing measurements. So the 700 meters, which is the length, will be represented by 3.5 centimeter. And the 400 meters, which is the width, will be represented by 2 centimeters. Thank you. We can now go ahead and get the area of the scale drawing. Since this one is a rectangle, we are going to do the normal formula of getting the area, that is length multiplied by the width. Our length is 3.5 centimeter, will be represented by the width will be represented by 2 centimeter. When you do length times width, you're going to get 7 square centimeters. So that is the conversion of real or actual measurements to scale drawing measurements. And we have gone ahead even to get the area in square centimeters. That is a good example of how we convert real or actual measurements to scale drawing using a given scale, or still conversion of scale drawing up into actual measurements using the given scale. So vice versa, you can convert from actual to scale drawing, or scale drawing to actual measurements given the scale to use. And the key thing to do is to make sure that you have converted that scale, the one you've been given in ratio, you convert it either in kilometers or centimeter, then you equate. You say, this is equals this, what about this? And by so doing, you are going to get the correct thing. We can still go ahead and get another example, example number five. So on a map, a rectangular plot of land measures 7 centimeter. A rectangular plot on a map measures 7 centimeter by 4 centimeter. When you see the centimeters, it means that this one is a scale drawing. This one is a scale drawing. In other words, it is a representation of the real measurements on the ground. So we don't have a house that is 7 centimeter. We don't have a road that is 7 centimeter, and that's why we are using the scale. So if the scale used on the map is one centimeter represents 3,000 centimeter. Like I said, in ratio form, in ratio form, 1 centimeter on the ground represent, 1 centimeter on a map represent 3,000 centimeters if it was in the actual ground. So we are going to convert these 3,000 centimeters that we've been given in the scale into meters. And we do that by equating. We say if 1 centimeter represent 300 centimeter, that one can also be written as 1 centimeter represent 30 meters. 1 centimeter represent 30 meters. After we know that, we can now convert. We say If 1 centimeter represents 30 meters, if 1 centimeter on the map represents 30 meters, what about now the measurements that you have been given? If 1 centimeter is 30 meters, what about our length of 7 centimeter will be how many meters on the ground? We do the conversion again. We do the conversion. If 1 centimeter is 30 meters, 7 centimeter will be represented by what? So we multiply. We say 7 times 30. That's our length. And get 210 meters. So that is our length. That is our length, which has been represented by 220 meters, represented by 7 centimeter on the ground. Now, again, we can do the same in the conversion of the width. The conversion of the width. Remember, our 7 centimeter was the length. Let us do the same with the width. If 1 centimeter represent 30 meters, remember that is our scale which we had been given in the question. If 1 centimeter represent 30 meters, if 1 centimeter represent 30 meters, 4 centimeter, which is on the map, will represent how many meters on the ground? So 1 centimeter represent 30 meters. So 4 centimeter will represent how many? So we just do the multiplication, 30 times 4, just like we did up there, 30 times 7. And we're going to get 30 times 4 will be 120 meters. 120 meters. We have converted, we have successfully converted our scale drawing to actual measurements using a scale of 1:3000. 1:3000. Please don't say 1:3000 centimeter. If you want to mention centimeter, just say 1 centimeter represent 3000 centimeter. That one is in a statement form. And in ratio form, it will be 1:3000 centimeter. Remember what we have done? It is very, very simple. You first of all work on the scale that you have been given. Once you convert the scale, the one we've been given here is 1:3000 centimeter. Convert that scale into a statement form and make sure you have two different units. On one side, you have the scale drawing, which is in centimeter. On the other side, you have real actual that is in meters. So we converted that 3000 centimeter to meters by dividing by 100, because 100 centimeter equals to 1 meters. So that was very simple. You are supposed to work on your scale. You're supposed to work on the scale that you've been given, and then you equate to make sure that you are getting the right thing. Now, our viewers, I want to welcome questions. I want to welcome question. Anybody with a question, you are allowed to send it. You're allowed to send it so that we can do our questions that you have sent from your side. I'm welcoming questions as you go through the examples that we have given. This is example 5. We have example 4 that you had been given. Go through the questions that I have given you as you send in your question. You are also supposed to go through the KCP papers right from 2000 up to 2019. Thank you, Lucy from Kisii. Lucy is asking if I can repeat how I did question 4. Lucy from Kisii, yes, I can hear you asking how I did question four. Now, question four, for the sake of Lucy, it was just a conversion of real actual measurements to scale drawing using a scale that we had been given. The scale we had been given was 1:20,000. And I said this 20,000 is in centimeters, though it is not written. The reason why it's not written, because it is ratio. In ratio, we do not have units. So the first thing you do, Lucy, at home and the others, you convert the 20,000 centimeters to meters or kilometers, depending on what the question wants you to do. In this case, we are going to convert the 20,000 centimeters to meters just by converting. You know very well that 100 centimeter equals to 1 meters. So you just divide 20,000, you just divide 20,000 by 100, and you get 1 centimeter represent 200 meters. 1 centimeter represent 200 meters. So for every 1 centimeter on the map, for every 1 centimeter on the ground, we are going to get 200 meters. So we just say, if 1 centimeter is 200 meters, what about our 700 meters? For every 200 meters, there is 1 centimeter on the paper. What about our 700 meters will be represented by how many centimeters on the map or on a piece of paper? So we multiply 700 meters. Not multiply, we divide. 700 meters divided by 200, and you get 3.5 centimeter on the map represent 700 meters. We do the same with the width. If 1 centimeter represent 200 meters, remember that is from our conversion of the scale. If every 200 meters, the actual measurement is represented by 1 centimeter on the ground, what about 400 meters will be represented by how many centimeters on a piece of paper, or rather on a map? We divide again, 400 divided by 200. And that one you're going to see, 2 centimeter is the one that we represent 400 meters. So to get the area of the scale drawing, you just take the length, which is 3.5 centimeter, you multiply by the width, which is 2 centimeter, and you're going to get 7 centimeter. I'm going to repeat example 2. I think I rushed there. I'm going to repeat example 2 just from the request of some students from Dhika. So example 2, what is the scale used if a length of 5.6 kilometer is represented by 4 centimeter on a map? On a map. Remember here, there are two dimensions, there are two proportions here. There is 5.6 kilometer that is the real actual measurements. There is another one that is 4 centimeter. And I told you, when you see the units of 4 centimeter, basically that one means it's a scale drawing. It is the measurement on a paper. It is a measurement on a book. It is a measurement on a map. So for every 4 centimeter, it represents 5.6 kilometer. So what the question is asking us here is we try and get the scale used. And in this case, we get the scale in ratio form. So we convert. We first of all convert the 5.6 kilometer to centimeters. We convert the 5.6 kilometers to centimeters. We convert the 5.6 kilometers to centimeter. You know very well that 1 kilometer represents 100,000 centimeters. For every 1 kilometer, there is 100,000 centimeters. So how do we convert 5.6 kilometers to centimeter? You just equate. Say, if 1 kilometer is equals to 100,000 centimeter, What about our 5.6 kilometer will be how many centimeters? So that one will be 500. When you multiply that 5.6 by 100,000, you're going to get 560,000 centimeter. You're going to get 560,000 centimeters. So if you want to get the scale, you equate now. So you say 4 centimeter represent 560,000 centimeter. What about 1 centimeter will be what? That means you divide 560,000 centimeter, you divide that figure by 4. Why are you dividing by 4? Because 560,000 centimeter represent, or rather it is represented by 4 centimeter. So we want to get 1. Remember, in the ratio we don't say 4. We can't say 4 is to 560. We need to simplify. So you divide that 560,000 by 4, and the scale used therefore will be 1 is to 140,000 centimeters. 140,000 centimeters. So I'm going to read your question. Some of you have sent in questions, very good questions. So there's a distance of 750 kilometers, You didn't say 750 meters or centimeters or kilometers. So I'll assume it is kilometers. So a distance of 750 is represented as a scale drawing by a line 2.5 centimeter. What is the scale used on the map? This is Julia from Eldoret. Thank you, Julia. We have seen your question, and I will try to go through it. Now, Julia is asking the scale used, the actual or real measurements is 750 kilometer, and on the map she gets 2.5 centimeter. So what is the scale that has been used? So the first thing we do, we try to convert your 750 kilometers to centimeters first. 750 kilometers. I'm trying to get my pen. So you convert 750. You try and 750 kilometers. So you convert this one to centimeters by multiplying. You multiply by 100,000. You multiply by 100,000, because 100,000 centimeters equals to 1 kilometer. When you do that, you're going to get 700. You didn't say whether it's meters or kilometers, so I'll assume it is kilometers. You're going to get 7.5. You're going to get 7.5 million centimeters. 700. And then you are supposed to divide this by 2.5. So Lucy, when you divide that by 2.5, you just divide that, this one by 2.5, that divide by 2.5. So just like when you remove this decimal, you add a zero there, then you are done with the decimal. Then you do by 25, one, then here by 25, you're going to get 3. So your scale use will be 1 is to whatever you got here. This is 3. This is 1 there. Then this is 1, 2. Mm-hmm. Then you're going to get 1 is 2. We don't have that 1 there. We don't have that 1 there. 1 there. So this 1 is not there. So we just have 3. This is 3. Then you do like that. Yeah, you're going to have something like that, assuming that the 750 you gave me was in kilometers. But going by the big figures I'm seeing here, it is as if that 750 was not kilometers, it was meters. Basically, you do the same. You first of all change the real measurement to centimeter. Then you divide by the scale drawing. You are going to get the ratio. You're going to get the ratio. So I'm sure you're getting what I'm saying. Suppose this 750 for Aline from Eldoret was in meters. So the first thing you do, you convert that 750 to meters. Not to meters, sorry, 750 meters to centimeter by multiplying by 100, because 100 centimeter equals to 1 meter. So you just add two zeros there. Just add two zeros there. So 750, Aline, that is meters. Convert it to centimeter. You multiply by 100. Multiply by 100. I'm assuming the 750 you gave us is meters. The other one was kilometers. So this one will be 750 like that. That is 75,000. So that means for every 2.5 centimeter on the map will represent 75,000 centimeters. So if you want to get the scale, you divide. First of all, you remove the units. Remember this side there was units, and remember I said in ratio there is no units. So you remove that, and you divide both sides by 2.5, and this side by 2.5. Then you remember you have already cancelled the units, so you are not going to have the units in the scale. So this one you cancel like that. Then remember how you balance the decimals. For this decimal that is down here, you can add a zero here. Then you forget about that decimal. You can erase that decimal like that. You can erase that decimal just by adding a zero up there. So you divide this one by 25. You divide this one by 25. You're going to get 3. Then your scale used will be 1:2. 30,000. 1:2. 30,000. Like that. 1:2. 30,000. 30,000? Yeah, that's correct. 1:2. 3,000. I think that 3,000, not 30,000. Make sure you get the correct zeros. That will be it. So if the 700 was kilometers, you'll get that. You'll get this. And if the 750 was meters, you're going to get something like that. Thank you. Another question. So hi teacher, it's Abigail from, I'm going to read your questions. Hi teacher, it's Abigail from Juja, Kiambu County. I'm asking, a distance of 5 kilometers is represented on a map by a length of 4 centimeters. What is the scale used? Again, this question for Abigail looks like the same question for the other girl from Eldoret. We're going to convert the 5 kilometers. So we are going to work out. Going to do that. So we convert that. So Abigail is asking. So the actual measurement is 5 kilometers. The actual measurement is 5 kilometers. And the scale drawing or the measurements on the map is 4 centimeters. So what is the scale used? So we are going to do the same thing I said. We start by converting this kilometer, we convert it to centimeters. And you can say 1 kilometer is equals, or rather it represents 100,000 centimeters. What about 5 kilometer? 5 kilometer will be represented by how many? So when you cross multiply like this, you're going to get 5. You add 2 zeros like that. Okay, like that. So when you convert 5 kilometers to centimeter, you're going to get 500,000 centimeter. 500,000 centimeter. So what this one means is that for every 4 centimeter on the map, this one represent 500,000 centimeter, the actual length. So since we want a scale drawing, we just do the way we did the other question. We divide, we remove the units. Then you divide this one by four, like that. Then you cancel, so that this side you can have one like that. Then this one, you divide this one by four. You can start by two, that will give you two. Just slowly, you can start this one by two, it will give you 250. To give you 250. Then you do by two again, it will give you 125. So your answer will be 1 centimeter, or rather one is to 125,000. Like that, 125. For every 1 centimeter on the map will give you 125,000. Remember, this is ratio. You don't put units. Thank you. So a piece drawn using the scale 1 is to 50,000. What is the actual length represented by 5 centimeter? So this is another question from another student of ours. She's asking, for the ratio given is 1 is to 50,000. I'm assuming that's correct. 50,000. That's the ratio given. But the measurement on the ground is, the measurement on the paper, not on the ground, or rather on the map, is 5 centimeter. So using these two, what is the real measurement? What is the real measurement? Somebody has asked that question. You didn't say your name and you didn't say where you are from. She has told us that on the map, there is 5 centimeter. And there is a scale that has been given, 1 is to 50,000. So 1 is to 50,000, this one basically means for every 1 centimeter, there is 50,000 centimeter. So the first thing you do is you convert the 50,000 centimeters to kilometers. 2 kilometers or meters, depending on what the question want you to do. So you start by converting this one. This one is already in centimeter. This one means for every one centimeter, there is 50,000. So we start by changing these 50,000 centimeters, maybe to meters or kilometers. Let's first of all change it to meters by dividing by 100, because 100 centimeter equals to 1 meter. So when you cancel that and that, basically you'll see that one centimeter will represent 500 meters. So this is the measurement on the map or on the paper, and this is the actual or real measurements. So what is the actual measurements now? So you say if 1 centimeter is equals to 500, what about 5 centimeter will be given by what? So when you convert that five, when you reciprocate and you multiply, you're going to get 2,500 meters. So this 2,500 meters is there, or it's our real, or rather our actual measurements represented by 5 centimeter on a piece of paper or on a book or on a map. If you want this 2,500 in kilometers, you just go ahead and divide by 1,000, because 1,000 meters equals to 1 kilometer. So when you do like this, just cancel 2 like that. So you can have 2.5 kilometer. This point has come because of these zeros. We only canceled 2 zeros and remained with 1, which now brings the decimal place there. So your 5 centimeter will represent 2,500 meters, or your 5 centimeter can also represent 2.5 kilometers on the ground. I hope I've answered you well. Now I go to Michelle. I hope that one is clear. Another student from Nyandarua, Michelle, you're asking, a plot of land is in a square shape. A plot of land is in a square shape. It is drawn to the scale 1:80,000. 1:80,000. Each side of the scale drawn is 13 centimeter. What is the actual area of the plot in hectares? So this one is a case of converting real scale drawing, which is 13 centimeter, to actual or real measurement using a scale of 1:80,000. So we can try to do that. We can attempt that by saying, so this, you have a square. So Michelle from Nyandarua, you have a square. That's a square. This square is 13 centimeter. This square is 13 centimeter like that. So when you see the centimeters like this, my dear learners, those ones means they are scale drawings. They are scale drawings. They are not actual. They are not actual. But if you want to get actual measurements, you use the scale that has been given, 1:80,000. 1:80,000. And remember what I told you, this is ratio form. It means for every one centimeter, there is 80,000 centimeter. That is what that scale means. Now, when you remove the colon there and you put an arrow, you can put an arrow or you just say represent. All of them are okay. For every one centimeter, represent 80,000 centimeter. So if you want your answer in meters, you first of all convert these. You convert these to meters by dividing by 100. Because 100 centimeters equals to 1 meter. So you're going to see that one will represent 1 centimeter. You erase this. So 1 centimeter. 1 centimeter will represent 800 meters. You can say that. You can still go ahead and now equate. If 1 centimeter is equals 800 meters, what about our length of 13? So you bring your 13 here. Bring your 13 there. I hope that one is the 3. Bring your 13 there. Then you ask yourself a question. So if for every 1 centimeter, you get 800 meters, 13 centimeter will be represented by how many meters? So you cross multiply this, you get 13 times 800. So you come here and you do your 13 times 8. You do here, this one is 4, carry 2 like that. Then this one is 10. So you're going to see 104,000 meters. So for one side, 13 centimeter, you're going to get 104 meters using the scale that you have given us. If you wanted to represent this in kilometers, you just come and divide the meters by 1,000. Because 1,000 meters equals to 1 kilometer. So you can do like that. Cancel these two. So this is 10. Like that. You get 10.4. So if you were to draw another scale drawing, if you were to draw another one now, if I can erase this. I want us now to draw another square shape. But now, instead of putting the scale drawing, we put the actual measurements. So we draw another square. Draw another square. My pen is letting me down. Draw another square there. But now, instead of putting the 13 centimeter, which was scale drawing, you write the one you got here. 10.4, this is 10.4 kilometer, or you can put the one in meters, or 10.4 meters like that. So if you want to get the area, you just multiply square side by side. And since your question was asking you get the area in hectares, that means you didn't have to go, since your question, Michelle, was asking the area in hectares, you didn't have to convert the ratio to kilometers. You only needed to convert the centimeters to meters. Once you get that, you multiply side by side to get the area, and again, when you get the area in meter squared, then you divide by 10,000. Because for every 10,000 meter squared, you get 1 hectare. I go to somebody else who is asking a question. I'm going through your question that you have sent to the studio. So a scale of map, this is still Michelle, a scale of map, one is to 25,000 on a map. One is 25,000 on a map. The map, the distance is 6.7 centimeter. What is the actual distance in kilometer? What is the actual distance in kilometer? This is Victoria from Embu. So Victoria, what you do, that scale which you have been given there, which is 1 is to 25,000, you convert 25,000 centimeters to meters. You convert 25,000 to meters by dividing by 100. Dividing by 100, can try and do that. Can try and do that with you here. Let me use my board here. We want to do Victoria's question. She has given us the scale of 1 is to 25,000. 1 is to 25,000. So if I can write there, 1, 2, 4. My pen is refusing to write. Ah, very good. So Victoria's question is 1 is to 25,000. This is a scale that you have been given. And just to explain this scale, 1 centimeter represents 25,000 centimeter. So this one means we can divide this one by 100, can divide that one by 100, so that we can have, 1 centimeter represent 25, represent 250, represent 250, represent 250 meters, represent 250 meters. So for every 1 centimeter, you get 250 meters, 250 meters. So what about 6.7, Michelle? What about 6.7 centimeter represent what? So for every 1 centimeter represent 250 meters. What about 6.7 centimeter will represent how many meters on the actual ground? So you reciprocate this, that only be 6.7 times 250. When you do this, you'll be getting the actual measurements in meters. Once you get in meters, you can easily divide by 1,000 to get the answer in kilometers. There's another one from Siokimao. This is Nikos asking, if a rectangular field measuring 560 meters by 800 meters is to be represented on a scale, This is Nikos from Siokimao. 560 meters by 800 meters is to be represented on a piece of paper or on a map using the scale 1 is to 20,000. What is the area in square centimeters? You have said square centimeter. That means this time we don't have to convert. Or rather, if you want the area, I suppose you made a mistake there. What is the area in square meters? Maybe that's what you meant. What's the area in square meters or no? In square centimeters. That means we are going to get the area of the scale drawing. So you convert the actual measurements which you've been given, 560 meters, you convert it to scale drawing using the scale 1 is to 20,000. So you can try and do that. Can try and do that with you. Okay, let me look for the space. Well, thank you. I can see the space there. Okay. So according to Nikos from Syokimau, we have been given the actual, which is 560 meters, and the width is 800 meters. 800 meters. So my dear learners, these ones, the measurements in meters, these ones are called actual measurements. We need to convert these actual measurements to scale drawing using a scale of 1:20,000. 1:20,000. So for every 1 centimeter on the map or on the paper, it represents 20,000 centimeter. So what we do first, we first of all change these 20,000 centimeters to meters. You just divide by 100. When you cancel like that, that means you'll say 200 meters represent, or rather it is represented by 1 centimeter on the map. So what about 560 meters will be represented by how many? So this one you just do 560 divided by 200 divided by 200. So you do like that. Then this is 56. You can divide this one by 2 to get 28. Get 28. You can divide this one by 2 to get 10. Then that 10 get 2.5 like that. So it means for every 1 centimeter, for that one will be the 560 kilometer or meters will be represented by 2.8 centimeter. Will be represented by 2.8 centimeter. You do the same with the width. You already said 200. You already said 200 meters is represented by 1 centimeter on the map. What about 800 meters will be represented by how many centimeters? So just do 800, you divide that one by 200. You get 4 centimeters. So if you are to draw that, you'll have something like this. I suppose it's a rectangle. Then where there was 560, you're going to write 2.8 centimeter. And where there was 800 meters, I assume that was the length because it's the longer one. So you're going to get here 4 centimeter. So if you want to get the area will just be length times width. So you just do 4 times 2.8. And when you multiply that, you're going to get your correct answer. You're going to get the correct answer. So if I can help you calculate that. Okay. That one will be 2.8 times 4. So this will be times 4 here. Get to here. This is a 3. This is 8, this is 11. But don't forget, there was a point there. This is obviously centimeter. And remember to put that 2 there to mean it is square centimeters. It is square centimeters. So guys, that one has been our lesson. That has been our lesson about scale drawing. I hope most of you have benefited. What you need to know that once you learn a new concept, you need to go through what you have done. You need to get more questions on scale drawing so that you can perfect or you can familiarize yourself with the questions or with the topic that we have done. Do a lot of follow-up questions so that you can master the concept of scale drawing. Now, as I wind up, as I finish, I want to thank all of you who have listened. I want to thank all of you who have turned in for this lesson. I want to believe that your day will be a success. Now, this one I address to all the students, especially the ones in class 8. There is no better way of doing your revision. There is no better way of doing your studies rather than using a very good exam. A very good exam, a very good set papers that can help expose the gaps that you know, that can help, that can guide you on your revision. As your maths teacher, I want to confidently say that I can refer you to very good quality exams that you can start doing daily just to make sure even when you're at home, you are benefiting. Signal publishers are the best producers of exams in Kenya. I can confidently say that from a teacher perspective. I want to refer anybody in class 8, anybody in class 7, anybody in class 6, and anybody in class 5 that you enroll to Signal Digital Exams. If you want the exam, please call these numbers. For standard 8, call